Building an ML application involves developing models, data pipelines, training pipelines, inference pipelines, and a set of validation tests. In this video, we will explore how you can manage your models using SageMaker's model registry. With the SageMaker model registry, you can track model versions, their metadata, group models by use case, and track model performance metric baselines in a central repository where it's easy to choose the right model for deployment based on your business requirements. This is often a key feature to enable transitioning the ML workflow from data scientists to ML engineers. When data scientists are working in their notebook or using training pipelines, they can register the models they train in a model group in SageMaker's model registry. Model groups will typically contain multiple versions of a model, each corresponding to an iteration of model training. These new versions could correspond to a new set of hyperparameters that was used to train a model, or a new version of a data set. When models are in the registry, MLOps engineers can pick which models make it to production by reviewing the performance metrics. Then they can approve models for deployment, and they can integrate this approval workflow with their CI/CD pipelines and have automated model deployment. They can view the lineage of these models as well, all from a single place. Now let's look at a notebook where we take a model that we've already trained and catalog it in the model registry. When we register our model in the model registry, we first create the model by providing the model artifact that's stored in S3. And then we specify which group the model needs to be added to in the model registry. Along with specifying the group, we can provide information such as custom metadata properties. For example, here, I'm specifying the model type as a CNN. We specify our model metrics. And finally, we specify an approval status. The approval status typically indicates whether or not the model is a candidate for deployment. When registering our model, we register it with a state pending manual approval, which means in the model registry, users have the ability to, through the UI, approve or reject a model for deployment. Now I'm going to run all of the cells in this notebook, and then we can take a look at what our new version of the model looks like in the model registry. Now that the notebook is done, let's look at our model. We open the model group within the model registry, and I can see there's one new version of the model that's been added. I have two previous versions, both have been approved, and this newly added version is in a state pending. When I double click on this, I can see some activity associated with the model. I can see my model metrics. And under settings, I have lineage tracking of my model automatically taken care of. This trial component corresponds to the trial component in the experiment that was used to train this model. And that information is automatically captured in the model registry. Along with that, I see the custom properties that I've added as well. Now, assuming this model is a good candidate for deployment, I can update the status, set it as approved, and this action can be used to trigger subsequent pipelines for deployment. All of the actions that you take in the model registry are integrated with EventBridge, giving you the flexibility to string together complex workflows for your model deployment. Now that this model has been approved, I see a new activity that's been logged to the model. And when I go back to this list of model versions, I can see now this third version that we added just now has been approved. The model registry serves as a good handoff point between data scientists and ML engineers, or people that are focused on model training and people that are focused on model deployment. I encourage you all to explore SageMaker Model Registry as a central place to catalog and manage all of your models.